Everybody put three fingers in the air. The sky's falling, the wind is calling, stand for something or die in the morning. Section 80, high power.
Visions of Martin Luther staring at me. Malcolm X put a hex on my future, someone catch me. I'm falling victim to a revolutionary song. The Serengeti's clone. Back to put you backstabbers back on your spinal bone. You slit your disc when I slit you my dish. You wanted to diss but jumped on my dick. Grown man never should bite their tongue unless you eating pussy that smell like it's a stale plum. I got my finger on the motherfucker.
Alright, what is going on, everybody? I'm back again. You know, David. Blah, 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 blah. I will not lie to you. This is not my first attempt of playing this map. This is not my second. It's not my third. This is more like my 15th? I don't know. But, a while back, I did the Easter egg to the Eisendrache. I did that solo, and I said that I wanted to do it again, or not that same one, but I wanted to do something like that again. So here I am today doing the Zetsubo No Shima Easter egg by myself, because it is, you are able to do this Easter egg solo. The games you're able to do solo, from what I know so far, is Origins from Black Ops 2, The Rising Drag, Zetsubo No Shima, and Garrod Crovy. So I'll be doing those maps solo, or I'll be completing the Easter egg solo. So I already completed I already completed the thing solo. I already know what to do. Compared to the other Easter egg, or compared to Origins and the Rising Track, this is not a hard Easter egg. It's actually pretty simple when you think about it. Outside of crafting, you know, like the wonder weapons and stuff like that, there really isn't much like Easter egg steps, if you know what I mean. Comparing this with the Easter egg for a Eisendrache, with this one, first of all, the start of the Easter egg is much slower. Because in order to start this Easter egg, you have to get the, you only have to get two wonder weapons. You only have to get the KT-4. Well, you have to upgrade the KT-4. So, guess you want to count that as like a second thing to get. They need to get the KT-4 upgraded, and you need to get the, skull. Skull is pretty easy to do. KT-4 is very simple. And the Eisendrache, what you have to do, basically, is you have to not only get all four wonder weapons, but there's like a completely, there's a really confusing like Easter egg that goes along with getting the four wonder weapons. So getting the four wonder weapons doesn't mean that, okay, you're basically, I'd say you're probably halfway, done with the Easter egg once you get the bows on DE, but, on here, I'd say you still have a lot more to go. Like, you're in, or no, on here, I say that on this map, I say once you get the KT-4, you're halfway. And I'm not talking about the upgraded KT-4. I'm talking about just the normal, like, weapon. That was actually dangerous for me. If I sound tired at all in this video, or, you know, I just seem different, indifferent, I guess, it's just because, you know, one, I already completed this, so, like, I don't really have, like, any, like, stress about it, but I am gonna feel, if I don't complete it in this run, I'm gonna feel very angry. And it's not like the usual anger where it's just like, oh, I didn't complete it, I guess I gotta do it again. No, it's more of like the anger of like, okay, I already did this once. Why the fuck did I fail again? You know? And the reason for me, you know, re-recording again, I forgot to mention this, but it's because the video came out super, super, super blurry and choppy. Like I know my DE video, that one was very blurry and very choppy, but this one was like even worse. Like with the DE one, it was like, you know, watchable. It was still pretty watchable. You know, you could watch it and, you know, you might cringe a little bit at the pixels you can literally count on the screen, but it was fine. This time around, it was not fine at all. So I was like, all right, screw it. I'm just gonna delete it, scrap it, and I'll just do it again. Because, you know, unlike DE, right? I saw how choppy it was in for DE, and you know, I did have half of the mind to be like, okay, let me redo it. But then again, I realized, I'm like, yo, it took me a while. It took me a while to get, you know, it done. So I don't think I really want to do all that over again. So I just decided to roll with it. So just like what I did with DE, I'll try to explain like kind of like what I'm doing. This game is still pretty old, so I'm pretty sure everybody already knows, but just in case for the people who don't know, what I'm doing now is, in order to get the skulls, you have to find three statues around the map. They have a symbol like this. You take these souls that are pretty dirty, you know, filled with blood, and you put them on there. Wait for the ritual to finish by, you know, clearing out the zombies and make sure they don't hit the skulls. You get the clean skull. Once you get the clean skull, you put it back on the statue. And after you get all four, you're able to get the normal skull after killing a few keepers. Now, I won't get the skull until probably after I get the K24, because the K24 actually helps me with one of the skulls. Because it's in like a, where the statue is, it's in a pretty hectic area, and a lot of guys spawn in. Like, there'll be like a lot of, get cooked up. There's like a lot of, I think the Thrasher spawns in at that time. The Thrasher spawns in, a bunch of zombies, spiders, all of them come in. So it's a good idea to just get the K24 for just extra assistance. Yeah, I think that's the word I'm looking for. So earlier today, I was actually or I guess by the time I'm recording this, it would actually be yesterday, but I was playing Battlefield, because Battlefield 2042 released. Well, it didn't fully like drop for everyone, but the what you call it, the pre-release, I guess, it came out earlier for the people who bought the Ultimate Edition. It came out a week earlier, so I was playing a little bit, but the servers were, Jesus, they were absolute garbage. They're not the worst I've experienced, but it is definitely not the best, you know, servers I experienced. I got kind of used to that, so I'm trying to like double sprint and shit like that still, you know. So far, it was pretty good experience, but yeah, I had to stop playing it so that I can, you know, have it in my mind to be like, yo, you have an Easter egg that you have to finish. So I'm pretty sure, I should be safe from thrashes and stuff like that only until I try to turn on the power. So I think the first Thrasher shows up, once I try turning on the power, that's when it shows up. Hopefully this is a spider round. That would actually help me out a lot if it is, because I can get started with one of the steps for the K24. Okay, it is. All right. Alright. So, one of the steps is, I go down here, I lure a spider inside of this trap. I hear the noises all over, but... Alright, here he is. Come on. Alright. So he's in there. I go up here. I raise up the cage. Spider comes up and we extract, butt juice out of him. Wow, I can't believe I just went down there. First time I ever went down to a spider, mind you. But, we're just gonna... Just gonna push past that. Get another quick revive. No, I gotta go open it from the other way. I'm just gonna open up as much of the map as possible, but nothing really else that I need. I just need to get inside of the bunker and, yeah. I just need to hurry up and get inside of the bunker. I think this is the first time I'm using the VMP in, zombies. From what I'm seeing, it's pretty powerful. Actually, no, never mind. It's not that powerful at all. Yeah, in Black Ops 3, this is classified as an assault rifle. Yeah. It feels more like an SMG, I'm not gonna lie. It just feels like a more powerful version of the, Vesper. I would say that I have this map, like, memorized, but, you know. Actually, no. I basically do. I basically have it memorized. I know where most things are. I will get tripped up on where certain things are, you know? I got silent there for a second because my first attempt at this map, I actually died like that because two zombies hit me, I didn't have jug, and I fell down there. I don't know why I thought it was a short enough distance to where I wouldn't get hit, but that was not the case at all. So I died there, and it was pretty laughable, but yeah. Open this up. Alright. Perfect. Phenomenal play. So the shield part is up here. Yeah. Right. Come on now, don't make me look like an idiot. Where is the shield part? Oh, here it is. Yeah, okay. This room costs same. Yeah. Alright. It's pretty expensive trying to get around this map. Actually, no. No, it's pretty inexpensive, to be honest. It's pretty inexpensive. Also gotta buy that door. How much is that door? I might just buy it right now. I have no reason, like, not to. Opens up more of the map, and it's not like an extra door where, you know, you just, like, there's no real point in opening that, you know? But that one is pretty, it's a pretty good map, it's an okay door to open. Alright. Or actually, no, I gotta get the zombie, hold on. One of my challenges is to shoot the heads off of infected zombies, so... I know that sounds weird, infected zombies, aren't zombies supposed to be infected already? Yeah, it is pretty weird. And by the look of that thing, it was actually about to become a thing there. The zombie was actually going to become a, Brutus? No, that's not what they're called. They're called, these guys. All right. But yeah, those guys, pretty annoying. Again? This is one of the reasons why they're annoying. They spawn in a lot. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot. I did not mean to do that. I'm gonna go and pick up another. I'm gonna go spin the box again for another weapon. Okay, this is not horrible. It's pretty bad, but it's not like the end of the world, you know? It's fine. It's fine. Alright, I just need a better weapon than this. And then I get the... Another one spawned in. He spawned in again. I heard it. I just threw that shit on his fucking dome. I thought it could go by. I could not. Alright, I'm just gonna pick up the can. Okay. Let's get the power on. So right now I'm trying to get a part for the Pack-a-Punch, and it's resting in one of these body bags. There it is. That here. So yeah, it's just like I did with the other one. Now the last one is in there, but... I mean, I could just go for it. There's no real reason not to. Yeah. So some of these zombies are actually zombies that... So they're, like... They are zombies, but they're not really zombies. And what I mean by that is, like... They don't add points... They don't add points to your total when you kill them. You know, none of that. They're just, like, there. Oh, fuck, I forgot you need another 1250. Get that. Damn. Okay. What else do I need? Oh, yeah, I need to kill this guy. I need to kill a guy that shows up soon. I'm gonna use my grenade on you. I'm not gonna waste my bullets. This is actually the first time, like, me doing this, and I've been, like, so close to, like, running out of ammo, like, so many times. It's actually funny. Well, it's really not that funny, because, you know, like, I want to hurry up and complete this. So, me getting this close to running out of ammo so many times is actually, like, you know, it's kind of making me, more worried, I guess? Yeah, it's like I'm focusing much more than I, like, think I should, you know? Cause, like, when I was first doing it, I was, like, kind of, like, just nonchalantly doing it, you know, just going along with it. But, like, now, I feel like there's much more pressure for me to finish this because I already did it. And the only reason why that one is not uploaded is because it looked bad. So now I feel like if I don't get this one, like if I don't get it like on this attempt, like it feels like, damn, I really should have kept the other one. You know? Or at least what I should have done is I should have at least kept it on my computer, because So here's the thing with like YouTube, like a bunch of my videos, like it's like blurry because, you know, YouTube compresses and does a bunch of shit with the video itself. So I already know that, you know, YouTube basically fucks up the video itself, you know, normal YouTube things. I tried to kill him before he became one, and it did not work. I'm just gonna spin the box again. I'll continue my thought that I had. Fucking die, please. Okay. Are these all the guys that's left? These are the last guys, right? Okay. Whew. Oh boy. Okay. Alright, continuing where I was. So, YouTube, like, once you post a video online on YouTube, it compresses the video and, you know, just does a bunch of shit to it. Just so that it's smaller in size and it's able to be shared by everybody, right? So not only does it decompress it, it also renders it in different, like, different qualities so that, you know, anybody can watch it. So, you know, when you go on a YouTube video and then you have the quality and then you can put it to, like, 144p, 240p, all that shit, that's not really, you're not really doing anything. You know, that's not a setting that the YouTuber themselves has to put in. No, that's more like just, you know, YouTube doing YouTube. YouTube does that itself so that everybody can watch the video, you know, even if you have like the worst internet. Yeah. So down here is a part for the K24. And also I skipped past it because I couldn't see it while going this way, but there's a part for PAP that I didn't see. I guess it's over here, right? Yeah, there it is. Okay. So yeah, I, you know, knowing this, I found a way to bypass like YouTube just messing up the video. So I could have tried it with that, but I honestly didn't want to take the chance because, you know, whenever I view it on my computer, I'm like, okay, it looks pretty nice. It looks nice. And I put it on YouTube and I'm like, oh my God, this looks horrible. What the hell? But I keep it up there because I don't want to just like keep, I don't want to delete the video and then re-upload it like that. I don't want to do that. So, now what I need to do is I need to find where that zombie is that just activated a spore. Where is he? He down here? Okay. I'm gonna take this because down here I need a certain type of water. That rainbow water, which is used for the upgraded K24. I need that. See this guy, he has the part for the K24. So that is what I need. What I'm actually going to do is I'm actually gonna... Never mind. Okay. I was gonna say I'm going to... Alright, that was creepy as fuck. I was gonna say I'm gonna wait to craft it. I'm just gonna get some points first and then craft it after. But, nope. Looks like I'm crafting it now. Okay. I think... So, should I keep the HBK or should I keep the KN? I'm gonna keep the HBK. So yeah. K24 could really be used like this, and I won't say that it's the most powerful wonder weapon, it's really not, but it's a pretty good wonder weapon for this map. I will say that. Alright. Grab the skull, please, thank you. I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't know why I looped around like that. Let's see. I guess I can do the other skull. If I run away fast enough, they shouldn't activate it. That's one thing that I realized. That, you know, if you run by like a fully grown pod or whatever, I think as long as you run away from the pod fast enough, I don't know if it's the zombies despawning, or I don't know if it's the pod despawning or the zombies like spawning elsewhere, but they don't activate it, so you gotta keep that in mind. Like those zombies, they're probably gonna activate that pod. I didn't hear it go off, so I guess not. Yeah. I'm gonna get Jug. Well, I mean, I guess I could do the... Actually, no. There was a time where I tried to do the boss fight without... I didn't have that much ammo. I forgot what gun I was using, but... Oh, yeah. It was the Vesper. I had the Vesper, and I ran out of ammo, and it was not fun. I had to, basically go back and, it was not fun. I had to go back and do it again. Like, do the whole thing again. It was not the best time. Before I did that attempt, I did another one. I did another attempt, of course. And on that, like, second to last attempt, I actually got... I got towards the boss fight. I was on the boss fight. I was gonna see. I was like, alright. I was just gonna check out how to really like do it, and you know, what I would need and shit like that, right? Just prepping for it, and I realized that your secondary weapon really doesn't matter as long as you have the Masamune, which, you know, actually is the weapon you need. Like it's not even like oh, you know, this weapon is not really needed, blah blah blah. No, you need the Masamune for this boss fight. You can't even start. I think you're soft lock if you go into the boss fight without the Masamune, you're actually soft lock. I don't know, I might be wrong on that, but that doesn't seem too far out the realm of possibilities. So I am gonna pack punch this. I'm just gonna pack it once. What? I'm just gonna pack it once for now. Where's the zombies? I want them to replace my shield, so. Alright, there we go. So right now I'm gonna go and head into- I didn't bring- For a while I realized that, you know, this is a good open area, so I put my shield- I always build my shield down there. But, yeah. I forgot I didn't build the shield down there, so. I built it in this area over here, right? Yeah. So if I don't build it down in the living quarters, I always build it up here in this laboratory. Don't know why. It's just a thing I do. It's no real. I don't really have a rhyme or a reason to doing it this way or doing it up here, but yeah. This is probably actually the worst space to do it now because you can get choked. But whatever, it doesn't matter. Let us commence the spider boss fight, which is so that I can get a part for the upgraded K24. Come on. All right. Don't worry. This time I will not run out of ammo, right? As long as you die. There you go. It died. Get away from me! God damn. Oh shit. What the hell is that? Bro, what the? Alright. I'm not gonna pick up Widow's Wine yet because I think you can get it as an extra thing there. Alright, I'm pretty sure you can get it as an extra perk slot, so. I'm gonna get Speed Cola and thing there for- what is he- what the f- that nigga was drifting on air- nah. I know you saw that, he was literally drifting on air. I have seen it all. Okay, let me kill you. I'm tired of you. The Thrasher, that's what this guy's called, he's a Thrasher. Okay. Let me see. Let me try to think. What is next? What is next? Let me do the... Let me get the thing there. The skulls. And actually, I think doing the skull will... It won't despawn him, but he won't enter in, so I can get like a little bit of a break from him. You know what I mean? Right? There's no way he enters in. He can't enter in. Okay, yeah, he can't. Okay, cool. Look at him, he's just waiting out there for me. Alright, I gotta make sure I don't use that much ammo. Even though I can basically one-shot the thing there. I can one-shot the Thrasher. Go.
I mean, is there no end to this senseless slaughter?
What the fuck? I don't know what those sounds are. I don't think those are a part of the Easter egg. Yeah, I remember. See, there's not really much, like, steps. Like, I'm telling you, there's really not. This is a pretty simple Easter egg. Also, if you can't tell, this is like the spot I usually use to train. It's pretty open, pretty spacious. I only got fucked over once, I think. Yeah. This is the spot I use. I like it, so I use it. Okay, so what I could do, right? Hear me out. So, I could get started with planting the plant. I think it would actually be better if I get started with doing that right now, actually. Hold up. Actually, first, before I do that, I can just plant the plant. I don't need to start the Easter egg first to plant it, so. So basically what I need to do is, with that rainbow water you see down there. Oh, wait, no. I think I do need to start it. Actually, no, I don't. I'm like forgetting and remembering the steps, like as I'm going, by the way. I just needed the skull. That's all I needed. I didn't need to start the main Easter egg at all. I just needed the thing there. Alright. So I go down here. I use the skull on this. Oh my god. I can't open the skull again. I hate this game sometimes. I really do. Wow, okay. I'm gonna have to do it next round. So, well, that didn't work out the way I wanted. The thing with the special weapon I don't like is that, like, even if, like, you see there, I have it on full. I have it damn near on full. I only took it out for, like, a second or two. But that was because I had to shoot the spore so I can get air. But it did spawn, okay. But if you take it out, yeah, like right now, you see how full it is? Like, I barely used it for a second, but I cannot pull it out right now. I think for now, let's just get this open. Okay. Alright, you know what? Let me get at least one challenge completely finished. Hold on. I know exactly how to do it too. Come on. That went better than I expected, I guess. Okay. So that didn't really work. I'm slowly thinking on why that didn't work. What I like to do with this next part is, speed cola and double tap, but I was like thinking to myself, I'm like, all right, let me not even like risk it, because if I go that way, I'm gonna have to pass by some like I'm gonna have to pass by some spores, and I don't want to risk having them turn into thrashers. Even though if they did turn into thrashers, would it help me more? I don't know. It would keep them safe. They would be, you know, much more safe, because I'm like, okay, I can't really, like, you can't accidentally kill a thrasher. I mean, you can, but it's much harder to. There it is. So I plant this, water it with the rainbow water. So you have to do that for 3 rounds. You have to do it like back to back. So each round you have to go back and keep watering that shit. So what I do is towards the end of one round, I water it, and then I stay up here, kill these guys, finish this round, and then I go down and I quickly go back to water it again. All right, so that's two. Now here's the thing, this is actually pretty dangerous now, because all the zombies are going to be spawning. Oh, this one pass. Fuck off. Oh my god. Okay. Just thank god I don't have a heartbeat monitor. Like, you know, monitoring my heartbeat while I'm doing this, like a lot of like speedrunners would do. Because that'd be, let me just get this open. See, I don't know about a lot of other people, but with me, I don't really use the special weapon outside of like Easter egg stuff. So outside of needing it for Easter egg, for the Easter egg, I don't really use it. Okay. Let me go. Never mind. I don't want to do it no more. I was literally seconds away from saying, alright, let me go and pick up another shield, I wanted to, like, quickly do it, like, while the other zombies were, like, fighting and shit like that. I was like, alright, let me quickly replace my shield, or whatever, and then, you know, the zombies basically said, no, you're not doing that. Oh, okay, I did all of them. Okay, nice. So, now that all the challenges are done, Okay. I just want them to be as far away from that spore as possible. Okay. So now I go here and I shock a specific, like, panel so that I can access a part of the map that you normally shouldn't be able to access. So going down here is another part for the upgraded K24, aka the Masamune. I'm just gonna keep calling it the Masamune. And that part is right here. There's a blue vial inside of his chest. You see, now here's the thing though. I don't need double tap. You don't need double tap because, like, the main point of this, of me playing, is not to get to a high round, right? The main point is me just getting to the boss. And as I said before, the boss fight, you don't really need, you don't need anything other than the Masamune. So I'm just gonna get Speed Cola. One of these gives you a thing, right? I think one of these gives you a perk, yeah. Oh no, it gives you a free perk space. Okay, shoot. What other perks are on this map? Oh yeah, stamina up. Let me get that. Yeah. Actually, it also works out because stamina up is right next to where Widow's Wine is, so I'll just get that while I'm over there. You know what I'm gonna do? Hold up, this might be a genius play. So I just need a gobblegum machine. Where is it? Here it is. If I can get anywhere but here, I can kill two birds with one stone. That is not anywhere but here. That is not what I wanted. Okay. So what I'm going to do, right, is I'm going to go back to my spot, and I'm going to try, I'm going to end this round. Should I just go straight? No, I don't think going straight there is the play. Is that what I did though? Shoot, crap, I can't remember if I went straight down right like on the third round. Oh, I don't have that much ammo on my KT4. Oh god. Maybe getting a thing there wasn't, maybe getting a double tap was actually the right move. Okay, so yeah, we're running into a slight problem. It's not that big of a deal, but it's kind of a big deal. but yeah, I definitely don't have enough KT4 ammo to finish the round, which isn't too bad, right? You know, expected. So it just means that I have to go and fuck. Please, 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 please don't end around. It did end around. Okay, I'm going immediately. I'm not risking it. I'm not gonna risk it. Let me just buy this. I am not gonna risk it one bit. I'm going straight there to water it for the last time, and yeah. I honestly can't remember how I did it, but I'm just gonna do it this way. Is there a pod there? There's no pod. Okay. We gotta move. Move. Please. Think I'm good? Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. Good. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm going to get a gobblegum. All right. So one of the parts of the Easter egg that is needed is a is the gobblegum anywhere but here. And that's because there's a part like off screen or off the map that you need to access to get a specific part for the main Easter egg. And what you call it? With getting this part, the way you get it is you need to have this perk you have to have this thing there anywhere but here. Which is not this one. Okay. This one is pretty good, but I don't need it right now. But I think I might just use it. I think I might just use it for the time being. So what I was going to do is I was going to go down there, wait, use, you know, the pot or whatever, get the thing I need, and then use anywhere but here to escape semi-safely. But it's fine. This will also work. The in plain sight will help because, you know, I can just like swim right by these guys if need be. Alright, and I get a pod too. Alright. So I think it's one to activate it. I gotta keep reminding myself, like, the button. Fuck. Uh-oh. This bad. Put the way. Okay, I'm good. I'm in the clear. We did it. Okay. Let's go, we are major. Oh my god. Did you see the moves I just put on that hold? Bro. Okay. Sadly, I just realized by the way my character is talking that I sadly don't have I'm not playing as Takeo, which is kind of sad because this is Takeo's map, and for the Eisendrache that was Dempsey's map, because that we had to kill Dempsey on that map, so it's kind of sad I can't really keep it thematic, but I'm not gonna sit here and keep restarting just so that I can get one single fucking character. No, you got me completely messed up if you think I'm gonna do that. You know, I did say that I was gonna sit here and explain most of the steps I'm doing, but it really feels like I feel like I haven't been doing that at all. But, and this game is how old? Like 10 years old? You know, this map came out like a year after the game released. I'm pretty sure everybody who cares about zombies already know either A, what's going on, or B, what I'm doing right now. I'm pretty sure everybody knows. Or everybody that's watching me knows. Who knows? Whatever. So now I have to get blue water. Or I don't remember if, you know, they say specifically it has to be blue water and the step will mess up if it's not blue water. I don't know the specifics of this step, but every time I've done it, I've always used blue water. So, you know, it's kind of like that same, it's kind of like that thing is like, if it's not broke, don't fix it, you know? So I plant it. So what I'm doing now, right, is I'm taking a plant, I'm planting it, I'm watering it, and then I'm shooting it with the Masamune. And I have to do that for 3 rounds. I have to keep doing that. So I plant, water, shoot. Since I'm at this standstill right now, what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna get one of the other steps completed, which is, you know, I need to like wait and do it as well, so like might as well get it over with now. Feel me? So I have to wait for lightning to strike again, and then I use the lightning for something else. Oh, speaking of it. Oh wow. Isn't that just lucky timing? You know what I think? I think even if this recording is horrible as well, like it's the same like bad quality, I think that I'm just gonna roll with it, to be honest. Why? Because I do not feel like doing this again. So if it's, you know, semi-horrible, then I'm just gonna roll with it. Alright. There we go. See, there's a thing you can craft called the gas mask, and I think what it does is, you know how when you run into the pod, the character like coughs and puts down his weapon and stuff like that? So I think with the gas mask, it just cancels that out, and that's really it. And to be honest, the pod isn't really much of a nuisance to me now, you know? I really want to get anywhere but here. There we go. Okay. So now I use this, puts me in this room, get this gear, and get out. Okay. So in that room, I didn't look around at all because I didn't want to get swamped by the zombies. But basically, what's happening in that room is it's just like a bunch of plans about the next zombies map, which is Golrod Provi. It's a bunch of like dragon eggs, you know, creations that they're using for, you know, like things that they're trying to see, like what they could do with these dragon eggs, you know, if they can weaponize them. Like, I'm pretty sure by round 23, I should have, I'm basically in the boss fight. I'd say round 23. So now all the pods are situated. So now I just gotta wait for this round to pass. And then I shall be able to get what I need. So the reason that I'm doing this is because, I don't know if I put this in the video or I kept editing it out, but basically a very large plane flies by, and I should actually just end a round. I don't need anything else. Alright. So a very large plane comes by, and I need to use this AA bullet right here. I need to use that to kill it, or to destroy it. That's basically it. Yes, a plant, for some reason, is able to distribute AA bullets. Don't know why, but it is. Oh, another one of them spawned? I really just need one zombie left. I think these are the last zombies. Pretty sure. Okay. So now I load this in. I didn't hear anything. And see, here's the thing about this step that I don't like. So you can't. There's a small little audio cue that tells you whether you loaded it or not. But if you fire it on accident, you gotta do everything again. Alright, it's loaded. I heard it. So I just gotta wait for the plane to come in, and then I shoot it, and blows up, and the gear falls out, and I follow the gear, and I pick it up. That's it. So I'm just gonna train these zombies around for a little bit until, you know, it spawns in. Oh, there it is. Oh shit, 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 shit. Okay, I got it. Alright. What you get for making so much noise on my YouTube video? Alright. This is actually the first time I've seen it crash over here. So where did it go? Here it is. Alright. And just like that, I literally have everything to do to get to the boss fight. Alright. I don't think I said that right. I have everything I need to do the boss fight. I can literally walk into the boss fight right now if I wanted to. But I'm gonna get a specific pack variant, I guess that's what it's called. I want fireworks. I don't want any of these other ones. Fireworks is like the best one, I think. I think it's the best one. I don't know. I definitely do not want turned. I just had Deadwire. Why is it giving me Deadwire again? Thunderwall. I just had Thunder. Oh my god. Oh my god. Can I not get... I don't think I could get it. Okay. I'm just gonna stick with Thunderwall then. I hope that zombie doesn't die because I need it. Alright. So, with the current ammo I have, I can still do it. Do the fight. So yeah, let's just head straight into the boss fight. The reason why I picked up the Bowie knife is because why not? Alright, let's do it. One reason why I love this part is because it's just like a slow descent. And there is like barely any music except for like that loud noise, but there's like barely any music and you're just like slowly descending. You're like, damn. So I think that's why the gas mask is used, because of there, but like I did, I just like ran right past it, so. Alright, here we go. Here's the boss. Any thrashers spawned in yet? Okay, there it is. I just need a max ammo to drop. Come on. Oh shit. There it is. Did he open up? I didn't mean to do that! One of his things open? No, not yet. What about now? Is it open? Yep. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Oh my god.
I'm dead. I'm not. Ooh, I got it. Let's go. Ooh, let's go.
Alright.
Oh, okay.
Your eyes. I recognize them. Almost as though they were my own.
Older Takeya.
Takeya Musaki. I did not believe I would find you in such a place. I was a warrior. I fought many great battles for the glory of our nation. For the honor of the dying samurai spirit. I was a hero. I share this memory. I have lived many of the same victories. I later learned that my victories were unwelcome. His betrayal was driven by petty jealousy. He knew I could endure anything. That I feared not even my own death. Punishment is one thing. This is cruelty. Who could be so evil as to desire another soul to endure such suffering? Who amongst us could be so dishonorable? Are you so blinded by your own loyalty? The orders came from the Emperor himself. My life, my path, is built upon a lie. This realm may have been corrupted and consumed by evil, but we possess the power to change things. A better tomorrow is only possible if we blow away the ashes of the past. None of us choose the means by which mercy will find us. But I am at peace. I understand what must be done. Will you be my Kaishakunin? It is my honor.
Oh, man. Oh, boy. What a ride. What a journey.
Three down, one to go. Guess it's you next, Nikolai.
Nein. There is something else we must know. There is a chain of events that must be set in motion. Call it our insurance policy, in case we don't like where we end up.
And as you can see, I completed the Easter egg based off, you know, you can see down below there, it gives you, oh shit, I didn't even realize the round like fully started yet. Okay, let me go up, I want to talk. All right, so yeah, I fully completed it, as you can see by the perk colas there, you know, just sitting there gleaming, shining, you know. Pretty nice. So yeah, that's it. That is the Easter egg for Zetsubo No Shima completed. Like I said, it is pretty simple, super simple. You know, you can do it. You know, it's so simple. You can do it by yourself. It's so simple. I can do it by myself. Look at that. But, yeah, that'll be it. So next will be Girl Rod Crovy. And just like with Zetsubo, I have no experience playing Girl Rod Crovy, actually. So yeah, because I don't know anything about Girl Rod Crovy, it's going to be pretty... Well, it won't be too difficult, but it's going to be quite annoying trying to get it, you know, get everything good and shit. So, yeah. Hopefully I'll, you know, make, upload more in the future. I definitely want to make some more, I want to make the Battlefield videos as well, based off Battlefield, you know, 2042, it just dropped. So, yeah. We'll see what happens in the future. Thank you all for watching. See you later.